Years ago, I made a choice to devote my life to improve the lot of others, first in the classroom and then in public service. Along the way, I was inspired by leaders like Ronald Reagan and Jeb Bush and people like my dad, who believed enough in us that they were willing to give everything they had of themselves. Last year, I was elected president of the Florida Senate by my colleagues, and we had a pretty remarkable session, passing initiatives to cap government spending, reform Medicaid and state pensions, bring excellence into the classroom, all while balancing the budget without raising taxes. So I decided to take this message to Washington with the singular goal of cleaning up the mess, and declared I would be a candidate for the United States Senate while serving as Senate President. And in the early going, I was encouraged, with endorsements from state and national leaders, support from colleagues in the Senate and House, and donations big and small. Yet, it became increasingly clear to me, and those around me, that the responsibilities I was managing on both fronts were in conflict. I truly believed I could handle both jobs, but I was wrong, and now I'm determined to make it right. Today, I'm announcing that I will no longer be a candidate for the United States Senate, nor will I seek any office this year or next. Instead, I am rededicating myself to finishing the job you sent me to do here in Florida. This was a very difficult decision for me and my wife, Stephanie, but this is the right decision. To those who have supported me in my race for the United States Senate, know that while I might be ending this campaign, I will not give up the fight. To my colleagues in the Florida Senate, please know I will do everything I can to help renew the promise that is Florida. And finally, to the people of Florida, I can't thank you enough for the kindness you've shown me and my family over the past few months. Steph and I will never forget that. You know, I put my faith in the simple idea that when you do the right thing, the future takes care of itself. But given Florida's challenges, the present won't. People are hurting, and we need all hands on deck. From my family to yours, Godspeed.